I just got back from the gym. I did my deadlift day. So I talked with Justin, and since my fight is next Saturday, 7 days from now, which is crazy, we are actually going to move two of my days from my 5 day split. We have switched to a 5 day split from here on out in this cycle for a couple weeks. And it'll be a longer cycle, and then we'll hit a nice deload and then go from there. But we're gonna kind of stretch this five day split into 2 weeks. So I've already done day one, day two, day three. Just finished deadlift day today. And then next Tuesday, I'm gonna do another squat day. And then next Thursday, it'll be a bench day. Probably some legs in there still, because now we're doing 4 days of bench, 4 days of squats, or at least some type of leg variation. So yeah, tons and tons of volumes for chest and for legs. We are hitting some back in there as well with accessories and sumo deadlift. We're still doing that for at least another cycle. And then I'll talk about if we want to switch or whatever, but finally have some Ghost pre-workout. I have been waiting for this for like a couple weeks, and for their new kind of version of their Legend product, they've been kind of switching some things around, and when I look up exactly what has been modified, I'll let you guys know, but I'm so excited.
Can you bring them?
All right, so I ordered 2 Sour Patch Red Berry, because that is my absolute favorite flavor. They do have a new flavor, peach, that I wanted to try out, but kind of sticking to what I know, that way I can really tell the difference between the version 1 and version 2 of the pre. So one for me, one for my dad, because he also likes Legend. But yep, so can't wait to try this out. I've missed this. I haven't had pre in like 2 weeks. I've been kind of taking some here and there from Monster, and my boss has bucked up supplements. I only take a half scoop of that because that has a lot of caffeine in it. I think it was like 300 milligrams at least. So yeah, a lot. But excited, excited, excited about this, and I'll let you guys know how I like it. All right, about to head out. All right, what's going on, guys? So I am heading back to the eye doctor at Walmart. They have a vision center now at the one near my house, and that's where I went to get my eyes checked for my fight coming up, because we have to have an eye exam, a blood test, a COVID test I'm also getting later today, and we had to send in like videos for our weigh-in last night. And I'm going back because we had to get my eyes dilated. That was part of like the whole exam that I had to get. But we dilated my eyes a little too early, because one of the rules, at least in Georgia, is you have to be able to see 20 and then slash like 200, which is like pretty blind. And I am without my contacts. Like, I can't see shit without my contacts. So what I was able to see before we knew what that rule was 20/240, which again is like you are blind. And then he dilated my eyes, and then we figured out what the rule was, and I tried to look at what the chart said for that particular like prescription, the 20/200, and I could not see it. He even went back to the 20/240 and again could not see it, and that's because my eyes were dilated. So he was like, well, I'll hold on to the sheet that I had to fill out for you, and then you come back on Saturday, which doesn't seem like a big deal, but it's kind of inconvenient. And after that, I have to go get my COVID test at CVS. It's a drive-through little swab. And then today is actually Ansley's birthday. So my boss, Amber and Dustin's daughter, she turned 6 years old, and she's having a princess ball. So I am dressing up as a princess, and I chose Mulan because she is like, if anyone knows me, I'm not very princessy. I'm very tomboyish. And so I tried to choose the least princessy, character out of them all. And so Mulan was it. And I basically have her fighting, like, I guess uniform. I don't know what else to call it, but it's kind of like a big robe. And then I have a sword with it. So I'm going to be dressing up as that later. And that's at 4. So right now I'm going to the eye doctor. I have an appointment at 2. And then my, my COVID test is at 2:40. which 20 minutes away from the Walmart, and I had no idea, so hopefully this little eye test won't take too long or else I'm gonna be late. But yeah, just wanted to catch y'all up on everything that I am doing. And today's crazy, tomorrow won't be as crazy. I'm not lifting, just a complete off day, and then we'll hit it hard in cardio the following week. So that's it. I'm gonna rush to this appointment and I will catch you guys in a few minutes. All right, what's going on, guys? So I'm trying out the Ghost pre-workout. I got two things of Red Berry because I had been without pre-workout for like 2 weeks. I had been using my boss's. He used Bucked Up. It was good, but I love Ghost flavors and just everything that they have in them and stuff. So I'm about to try it and I'm so excited. So let's see how it goes. Oh my God. Oh, that's 10 out of 10. Oh, I miss this stuff so much. Oh my God, it tastes so good. Definitely gonna be chugging this, or at least getting my money's worth, because oh my God, this stuff is so good. If you haven't tried the Red Berry flavor, I highly recommend you try that one. That is my favorite. I want to try the peach flavor, but I think I'll get that next time I'm on the site. And you can use code BCN to get 20% off. Save money where you can, and yeah, you will not regret it. That's, oh my God, that's so good. I'm gonna enjoy this. I'll catch you guys later. What's going on, guys? It is March 16th and I am officially 3 days out from my official weigh-in for my fight, and we are steadily starting to decrease my weight with water cut. So I also had to run 3.5 miles before this and just feeling super fatigued, and so as a result I didn't get to squat as much as I'm capable of, or I know that I can lift. Body was just completely drained, and because earlier last week when I did my first squat day, I got 260 for the same thing, and today I only got 225, and it felt honestly heavier than the 260. But that's gonna come with it. Just water cutting is not fun, to say the least, and these next couple days are gonna be pretty grueling. And I'm gonna try and lift bench on Thursday, but we'll see how that goes. It might be light like today was, like, and not get as heavy, nowhere near as heavy as I'm able to get. But we also did front squats, 3x3, my other squats were 3x3, and everything else is 5x5. I had a leg extension, leg curl superset, hip adduction, abduction superset, as well as a vertical pull of choice, and finally a glute ham kickback machine. So that was it. Gonna roll with the punches these next couple days. It'll be hard trying to get these, honestly, 7 pounds off before I get to 122. I'm sitting at 129 pretty steadily, and I think it is because I'm holding a lot of water. So hopefully I can get those pounds down, because I'm honestly eating as if I would for my regular, like going into a powerlifting meet, and normally I drop weight pretty quickly, but right now I'm not dropping as much, and I'm doing more cardio and eating pretty light. So I think it is the extra water that I'm intaking, and I'm just holding on to it. So we'll see how these next couple days go, but I'll keep y'all updated on it. And one more lifting day, probably super light, not the designated RPE, but we'll do what we can. So that's going to conclude this commentary, and I'll catch y'all in a few.
What's going on, guys? It is Wednesday, so we're 2 days out from Lance. I've just finished running 3 miles. We are officially in water cut right now. So basically, I've been drinking like a gallon a day, and now it's cut down to like a quarter of water. Like, I don't even know how many hours. This is only my second quarter of water. Basically like a sponge and just trying to squeeze all that water weight out. I just ran 3 miles tonight, ran 3.5 yesterday, and on top we have morning workouts. So doing a lot of cardio, not drinking a lot of water, and kind of sucks. It's my first water cut, and it's not even that bad compared to what other people sometimes have to do. But I still have, I was 126.2 after workout this morning, so interested to see what I am right now. I'm gonna go home, shower, weigh myself, and then eat. And then we'll see how much more we have to cut off tomorrow, because I have to be 122 by Friday at 1 o'clock. That's when weigh-ins is. So keep y'all updated on that. I'm just gonna go home, shower, eat, and repeat it tomorrow. So I got training tomorrow morning, probably run some more, and gotta get some last minute things for the fight. So I'll catch y'all then. What's going on, guys? So I did have work this morning at 6:30, did all that with the kids, dropped them off at school, and then I did some kickboxing this morning. I weighed in, the scale did a cruel thing to me. It said 122.6 and then it went up to 123.4, so I tried weighing myself again and it was 123.4. so did some kickboxing this morning with Dustin, trained a little bit, and after I was still kind of sweaty, but I was 122.2. I got home and then I weighed myself again after I dried myself off, and I was 121.6. So no water and food still. I haven't had anything today. So all I'm really thinking about is just weighing in and then drinking a ton of Pedialyte and eventually having a lot of food. And then we're supposed to weigh in, and then we have face-off. And so David and I are meeting at Legacy right now. We're gonna get another cooler from Kroger and then head down there. It's down in Midtown at District that we're weighing in. So about a 40-minute drive for us. And then we'll do all that, face-offs, and then come back for work. So that'll be it. But once weigh-ins is done, I am literally, the second it's done, I am going to drink so much Pedialyte. Probably not all at once, but definitely start sipping on it, because I have like the driest mouth right now. It's disgusting. But yeah, just want to update y'all. I'm pulling up, meeting David, so I'll catch you guys later.